Hi, today I'm going to show you how to turn your monitor from this to this. Let's check it out. The lighting behind your screen is called YINICE Ambilight, but the name of the active one is mostly called Ambilight. There are many ways to get Ambilight on your TV or monitor. For example, if you are looking to buy a TV, you can get Philips TV, which actually comes with Ambilight pre-installed in the TV itself. Or if you want an Ambilight kit to install on your TV, you can get one of those totally not expensive brand Ambilight kit. But if you are on a budget, like me, you can get cheap China Ambilight kit. This whole setup only cost $20 for me. Now, before you buy a kit, check your monitor size. I own 24-inch monitor and I need about 1.5 meters for full size installation. But at the time of purchase, there is no 1.5 meters option available. So I got 2 meters instead. Now that we know how long we need, let's check out what's inside an Ambilight kit. These are the items inside the package. Here's what we got. 2 meters LED strip. YINICE Ambilight controller box for enthusiasts. It is Arduino Uno Level 3. Power adapter and the power cable, which actually doesn't fit. You see how it can be bended when plugged in. Anyways, the last thing is a 1.5 meters USB cable. This corner connector is an extra. It costs $4.20. That is all inside the package. Now, for the installation. First step is to clean your monitor so that the glue can stick easily. After that, you apply the LED on your monitor. You can start from any corner you want, as you can set offset later in a software. It is highly recommended to apply the same number of LED on both vertical and horizontal sides. Like, if you apply 15 LED on the bottom, you should have 15 LED on the top, and vice versa. Now, in the official video here, you can bend the LED strip, so you don't need the corner connector at all. But if you don't like bending the LED strip, corner connector is the solution, and I will show you how I set it up. Get 2 plastics and 1 PCB out of the package. Check those small plus icons and align it correctly. This is important. If you connect it wrong, it will not work. Open up the lid. Insert the PCB into the plastic. Close the lid. Then do the same for another side. And for the LED strip too, plus 5V going to plus connector. After all that trouble, apply the LED strip to the monitor.
do the same for all sides. Finally, you can choose to cut excess LED strip or not. This is what it looks like when you cut the LED strip. And this is when you don't cut the LED strip. Just stick it to the back of the monitor. Congratulations, you got the hard part done. All that left is to connect all these cables together and set up the software. The video should be pretty much self-explanatory. If you still don't understand, you can pause and take a look at this picture. The software developer recommended is Ambibox, and so we will use it. I will leave the link in the description below. Download and install it. During installation process, choose Ada Light. Then launch Ambibox and open it from taskbar. Expand more settings. Check your port by going to Device Manager. Open up Ports section and you should see USB serial CH340 with a random COM number in a loud bracket. If you don't see it, then you have to download the driver manually. Link in description below. Anyway, you take the COM number from Device Manager. For me, it's COM6, so I have to choose COM6 in the port setting. Next, what you need to do is choose how many LED beads you have applied. If you didn't cut the LED, then you should know the number from what you had bought. Otherwise, just count. After that, you expand setting again and click show alias of capture, then wizard capture zones. You will see a bunch of numbers. Those represent your LED on the back. Now, before doing anything, choose your placement zones between 4 size or 3 size. And tick no corner if you had used the corner connector. Now at this point, if you have placed the LED evenly, you can input the number of LED, either horizontal or vertical. Choose offset of the first zone so that it starts from the correct position. Then choose which way to the light flow based on how you apply your light strip. And you should be pretty much done. Click apply and enjoy. But what if you didn't place the LED evenly, like what I just did? Well, it turns out that you can move each of those LED manually. So do move it to match the LED on the back. Doesn't have to be precise, just close enough is fine. It's going to take a long time, so I'm gonna fast forward for you. This is what mine look like after I finish moving it. Now, before we go and enjoy our movies, let's change a bit of additional settings. Go to additional configuring of zones. What I like to do here is bump up the saturation of all zones. Tick for all zones checkbox and increase the RGB to the max. Also, bump up the saturation on the light side to the max. Next, you will want to reduce the gamma collection. What this option does is apply white to your color. The light will be off on black color without this option. Default setting is 100, which is a bit too bright on black. I like to set it at about 55 to 60. Then click save settings and enjoy the light.
It seems fate still doesn't want you dead.
Just amazing. With all these amazing things, why would you want to buy an expensive Ambilight kit? Well, as much as there are pros, there gotta be cons. As you notice, this light rely on USB data and a third-party application, which could have a little bit of performance hit. And for gaming-wise, it doesn't work with full-screen games. Has to be borderless or window mode for it to work. Also, it doesn't work with non-Android TV. Unless you hook up your PC or Android TV box. Otherwise, it is just as good as those expensive Ambilight kit. Now, thanks to you for watching. And if you like this video, don't forget to hit that like button. And if you want to see more from me, smash that subscribe button. And I will see you guys in the next video. Bye bye!